Pure Majestic, Legend and the Myth, One and Only Odin Sphere. Coming from the people who known as Vanillaware, the most majestic people who just make fairy tale what you can play as a game. Odin Sphere been very unique, very majestic, standalone game, still are, will be, I suppose, right, and will be remembered in history as well. One of the best RPGs in history with me, Игорь Чернов, as always, RPG Legends, again, hello, guys. So, it's like, again, it's like, talking about, like, one of the most best and one of the most glorious, I suppose, right, and just, no, deserve to mention, actually, games, which is RPG games, obviously, right? This is RPG Legends, actually, right? And I'm being the guy who just play a lot of them, almost all of them, actually, right? And totally just put just only best of the best in this list as well, actually, right? But, I mean, it's kind of obvious, actually, that judging by the looks, judging by the art style, judging by the gameplay as well, this still, on Odin Sphere, actually, still stands as a golden standard, I suppose, of how you make an action RPG, 2D action RPG, right, as well. And, you got, a lot of games, actually, coming from Vanillaware, actually, right? Like, Dragon's Crown, right, or just Princess Crown, if I'm not mistaken, actually, right? If I'm not mistaken. Well, it's totally need to be Dragon's Crown, right? Also Muramasa, Demon's Blade. A lot of people will say, actually, what Muramasa is kind of more superior, actually, right? And it's basically V, you know, just game coming from the V, right? And at some point you can agree with them, but it's like, I think the opus magnum of Vanillaware, actually, is objectively it's Odin Sphere, right? The game originally being released on PlayStation 2, when we just done the remaster on PlayStation 3, right? Still, sadly, never been released on PC. It's a big waste for Vanillaware, but that's the contract stuff, actually, what we do in Japan, I suppose, right? If you are a Japanese developer, they basically just force you to support the national product, like PlayStation, for example, or Nintendo, or else, I suppose, right? And PC for them is basically, you work on PC, right? You're not supposed to play on PC, actually, in Japan, as far as I understand, and just find the PC gamer, actually, even in America, actually, it's kind of, most of the people play on consoles, actually, right? And just the people who buy games, at least, right? And obviously, customer is always right in this way. But sometimes they just release games on PC as well, like Persona 4, and become overwhelming success, actually, right? For any people or any person, actually, who just want to play, release their game on PC even after, 10 years, actually, or decade, I suppose, right? Same goes with Odin Sphere, right? I'm even convinced what a lot of people still waiting, actually, right? This game coming on PC. I myself, actually, got this piece of gameplay. I play on emulator, right? On PlayStation 3 emulator at 4K, just to test it, right? And I can tell what game at 4K look just unbelievably beautiful. It's like this art style, these effects, I suppose, right? The way how just and it's kind of funny what all it's like everything about this game is pure harmony, right? It's just it's like this music is just pure majestic. The characters, the character development, how the characters look, like every one of them. If it's supposed to be specific, it's like even you supposed to be specific, right? You being like a guy who just really like dark fantasy games, and you don't want to play as this Vibe-lookish, I suppose, Valkyrie, right? And all of them actually look kind of specific, right? But you totally understand what character development has been like on way, way different level compared to any other games, actually, right? Even Dragon's Crown is more like it's more like Golden Axe on steroids, I suppose, right? Or Golden Axe with I don't know, just World Hub, I suppose, right? The place where you can return, buy new weapons, new armor, and go forward, actually. But it's kind of funny, what in Dragon's Crown, nobody talk about this, but in Dragon's Crown, we're supposed to be, like, very, just specific game design idea, what you need to just complete all levels, what you already complete again to just reach the final boss. It's very specific idea, and nobody talk about this on just when they review a Dragon's Crown, for example, right? They talk about, like, the game is just look extremely beautiful, characters look extremely sexy, like this barbarian girl, I suppose, right? Or sorceress, especially, actually, right? Everybody still remember the big booba, I suppose, right? And still, just people just continue to just put this picture when we talk about Dragon's Crown. And Odin Sphere is not about... It's more not about being a fan-service game or a semi-fan-service game. It's about being a game. It's actually extremely good, extremely phenomenal, actually, action RPG. Right? This combat system, 2D system, actually, right? This rating system. So basically, whenever you fight, you got a rating, right? Like in, I don't know, just in some, I suppose, old games like Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, actually, Battle Nexus, right? After every level, well, you can't call it an action RPG, obviously, right? It's just some sort of a beat 'em up or just Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles game, actually, right? But you see, it's like after every level, you got a rating. How you fight, how you, it's like, in what time you just complete the level, actually, right? And you basically got a rating, like A, B, C, or SS, I suppose, right? In the end of the level, this game also got, like, some certain rating, actually, what you just supposed to just gain after completing the level, and they give you, like, additional rewards, actually, for it, actually, right? So if you put an effort, if you've been a hardcore player, this game totally just reward you, right? But above that, it's like the battle system is extremely attractive, and just what one character can do from what position, actually, right? It's like, it's totally just reminds you just about, like, about the best slasher games, like the Devil May Cry 3, for example, right? You just can do almost combo from any position, right? You can just fly high, you can just throw enemy up high, actually. Start to just kick his butt, I suppose, in air, right? Then just go down and just finish him, right? Above that, you got, like, this skill tree system, actually, right? What you can use, because you got, obviously, experience points, and it feels way different from any JRPG you play ever in your life, right? This game is extremely unique, is extremely special in the way of art, in the way of music, in the way of everything, and all of these characters, what you can see on the poster, they all playable, right? And yeah, like, a lot of them totally look like typical fairy tale characters or even anime characters, I suppose, right? But this game is totally just stand tall, actually, on being a fairy tale, not anime game, right? Not just some JRPG game. It's need to be fairy tale. Even if it's supposed to be Japanese fairy tale, you totally just understand what it's pure magic, actually, right? Still, for any type of a child, I suppose, right? For any type of a person who really want to experience, like, the true fairy tale, like Wizard of Oz or something like this, actually, right? This game is extremely special and just, everything about this game tells you what it's just on another level of production, right? Way how the character moves, actually, right? Because it's an action RPG, you got also this location system, actually, what you can go, like, up, down, left, right, I suppose, right? Oh, usually you can only just go left and right, obviously, because it's just it's not isometric RPG, it's 2D RPG, right? And it's need to just mention, it's an RPG. This whole game proof what RPG got its own style. You totally feel when you play something, some adventure game, like Legend of Zelda, for example, right? And still people just think what Legend of Zelda is an RPG, but it's not. It's an adventure game. Always been. And always will be. It's an adventure game. It's about exploring. It's about no, but it's not an RPG. Yeah, you got RPG elements, like a little one, right? But it's the same what you just call like Castlevania an RPG, like Castlevania Symphony of the Night. But we totally know what it's. It's own game in its own genre, like Metroidvania, I suppose, right? Or Castlevania, obviously, right? Because it's all about like exploring the castle and just, oh, well, yeah, at some point you got like this raise your character system, actually you can level up and all, you can equip your character, but it's totally just way different from Jade Empire, right? It's all way, way different from Baldur's Gate, and you totally feel it actually, right? And at some point, this is supposed to be something just what unite all these RPG games, like Odin Sphere as well, actually, right? And you totally feel what is game is just. It's need to be an RPG, right? And it's just stand tall to be in, like, inside this RPG genre, actually, right? Whatever you call it, JRPG, I don't know, just fairy tale RPG, doesn't matter, actually, right? So, yeah, it's like, it's kind of strange, actually, what still the game never been released on PC, right? Still got remakes actually on every console. Oh, okay, every console. Actually, it's available only on Sony, as far as in Sony store, as far as I understand, actually. Right? You also can play it on emulator, but it, obviously it's a piracy for always people who be like, it's a piracy, blah, 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 right? But we all know what it's like. You gotta steal to eat, gotta eat to steal, and all this shit like this actually, right? Coming from Aladdin, right? You totally understand what it's like. You really want to play it on modern resolution actually, right? And with I suppose modern features, right? Like you can just buy it on Steam or something like this. And it's kind of funny what every year, almost every year, or every 5 years, actually, I suppose, I'm just starting from 2015, VanillaWare continuously teasing PC players and be like, hey guys, like, just, you wanna play, like, Odin Sphere or any other game, like Dragon's Crown? You'd be like, yes! And like, oh, well, maybe next year. And guess what? Never happened, right? So, yeah. Also, I just continuously just forget to mention what it's like. I also just need to mention about like the best of the best version of any particular RPG what I actually mentioned in this list and just put it in this list as well. So basically, starting from PlayStation 3 or playing this game on emulator, game look and feels almost perfect. 60 FPS, as far as I understand, it's available on you can play it at 60 FPS on PlayStation 3 as well, as far as I understand, actually, right? So if you never play it, right, you need to play it. It's not about like what I just will just talk about, like the gameplay features or the character development or all this stuff, boring stuff like this. It's all about the feeling, right? Because a lot of people, especially competitive players, I don't know, just esports streamers, I suppose, right? Or any type of people who just play games like it's supposed to be like a smoking, actually, right? Like Dota or League of Legends, actually, right? We basically play only one game and be like, why I need to just play like one particular single player RPG or game if I can just watch it all on YouTube? It's all different. Watching games on YouTube, it's kind of obvious, but it's not obvious for all these people, actually, right? That's why I'm telling you, actually, this, right? So basically, it's all about the feeling. It's all about the feeling, it's all about the real deal, actually, right? So, the real deal is playing a game. And another just way is just to watch a game on YouTube, actually. It's way different, right? I mean, this battle system is so... It's one of the best RPG... action RPG battle system what I experienced in my life. VanillaWare totally need to just do something like 3D RPG. Isometric JRPG, like action RPG, they totally need to do this. I totally understand what they just doing their own games in their own style, but say how game plays, it's another level of quality. It's really just good to play it like, I don't know, just like this action RPG style game actually, right? When the character can move like this from you can jump, you can just, I don't know, just you can just move enemy just with you, like as like up to the up to as like you can basically just, I don't know, just no, any possible, I don't know, just action is available to you actually, right? From any position, right? And you don't really feel yourself like you're playing at some point Devil May Cry, but 2D Devil May Cry. But this is an RPG and it's a fairy tale RPG. Coming from Maniaware, with all this just style, actually, right? The story is also supposed to be kind of extremely majestic as well, because you got like these all-known characters, actually, right? What you can just, what you can just mention, they been mentioned, actually, in different myths, I suppose, or legends, actually, and they all been put it in and just been the part of its own lore, I suppose, right? Or its own soup of lore, actually, right? What we make in this game. And, yeah, obviously, if we're supposed to be a Valkyrie, we're supposed to be an Odin, obviously, Scandinavian stuff, actually, right? But above that, you got, like, an opposition to Odin, actually, right? The guy who just want to kill him for what he doing, in his past, actually, right? And this game is extremely long, actually, as well, right? You got, like, so many missions, actually, right? What you need to complete. This game is kind of hardcore as well, right? If you want to just dig deep, actually, this game... Oh, some people will say, actually, what we like, this game is kind of casual and all, actually, right? I see this type of people. Well, but they talk about... They just saying this about any particular game, what they just actually play. It's easy. I don't believe them, actually, right? It's like all these people who just saying, like, what, it's like some, I don't know, just Trails games, I suppose, or Ease games, or Nightmare, it's supposed to be easy, and you'd be like, keep talking, man, right? It's like, this game is semi-hard, moderately hard for any type of person, I can tell, actually, right? Because to just understand the battle system, understand this location system, actually, right? You also got, like, this item system, what you can actually raise, right? You got a fruit, actually, what you can put, you know, just and just raise it as a plant, I suppose, right? And raise some... fruits, actually, what you can gather, right, and just restore your HP with it, actually, right? You got, like, this sound, just this kinda, this game totally reminds me of Tales of Games, actually, in this way, but you don't have this location, like, battle locations, actually, or arenas, I suppose, like in Tales of Phantasia, for example, or Tales of the Abyss. You basically got a, whole location for you to explore. It's only, obviously it's 2D, but the backgrounds, right? The backgrounds on overall style. I mean, look at how the game looks, right? How, like, all this transition screen, all this animation, these cutscenes is just bellissimo, right? It's just, it's another level how you cook a game. It's another level how you make a game. Vanilla, my personal respect, and I don't know, if only I can bow, actually, but if I bow right now, I will just, I got microphone in front of me, actually, right? So, my deepest respect to VanillaWare. Still wait for this game to be released on PC, same with Dragon's Crown and any particular game that they want to release. VanillaWare, please make it happen. Odin Sphere is just one of a kind. It's a masterpiece and well-deserved placed in RPG Legends with me, Igor Chernov. Again, best of the best RPGs in history. Without bullshit. Finally, you can't find any topic like this on internet, actually, right? Like on the IGN, I suppose, or any I'm just like, you got like top 20, top 100, top 1000, I don't know, of RPGs. And they never mentioned something like this. For what reason? Nobody knows, right? But these games, totally, like Alcahest, I don't know, just like Arcus Odyssey, this game, actually, right? It's kind of funny, what people never mention them, actually, right? But that's why I'm exist, actually, right? So yeah, Odin Sphere, one of the best, I suppose, it's totally one of the best, actually, like top, I suppose, to top 1 or top 3 totally actually 2D action RPGs. 100%, right? And one of the best RPGs overall in history. And you don't even need to just... I don't even need to prove it, actually. I mean, look how the game looks. How... Even on... What happening on screen? It's just madness, right? How she moves, how you can just make all this combo-shwombo shit, actually, right? It's, and you got like this score system, actually, right? You got a motivation above what you earn experience, right? After every level, you got these artifacts, I suppose. You got these items, it's just... Everything about this game is pure magic, it's majestic. Play it if you never played it, right? You totally need to do this. Odin Sphere, well-deserved place in RPG Legends.